In this shoemaking tutorial, I collected 5 my best shoemaking tutorials of this year, 2020. In these tutorials, you will find most important things, most basic things that you as beginners in shoemaking should learn when you start learning shoemaking. Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses. I think that you want to have comfortable shoes that will fit your feet perfectly, and maybe this is the main reason why you want to make shoes for yourself. So, first thing is to know what is the right shoelace size for you. That's why I created this tutorial where I show how to measure your feet to know what is the shoelace size for you. In this shoemaking tutorial, I will show you a simple way how to measure your feet correctly to know what is the right shoelace size you need to work with to make bespoke shoes that will fit your feet perfectly. Now you should pay attention how you place your foot on the paper. Measure the longest feet, okay? This toe is the longest, so I will place the pencil to this toe. Place the pencil in 90 degrees angle. Same shoelace size may have a different width, so you need to know what is the width of your feet to have correct shoelace size. Next step is to choose shoelace type. Yes, there are many shoelace types, so which one you need to choose to make many different footwear types? Yes, there is the perfect, I call it perfect, shoelace type that you can work with and make 10 different footwear types. And that's why I made this excellent tutorial where I show what is this perfect shoelace type, what shoelace type you need to have to make 10 different footwear types. When you start learning shoemaking, you need to have tools and materials. But as a beginner in shoemaking, you really don't need to have all shoemaking tools like experienced shoemaker have. So here you are limited. And that's why to make different sneakers types, sneakers with high top and with low top, it's better to work with simple palm plus with low heel with a rounded toe shape. First thing that you need to master is making basic pattern. There are two types of basic patterns, this one and this one. This one is for footwear, for court footwear types like Oxford shoes, derby shoes, moccasins, boots. And this one is for pumps, for flat ballet shoes. So I made a tutorial where I teach how to make this basic pattern that you can use to make almost all court footwear types. That's why you need to watch it and learn how to do it. Basic pattern is the exact copy of your shoelace. This pattern repeats all curves, all lines of our shoelace. And it must be very precise. Why? Because based on this basic pattern, you will construct most of the different footwear types like Oxford shoes, derby shoes, boots, etc. Here in this tutorial, I wanted to show how to make basic pattern very fast. So I attach here masking tape only along the length of the shoelace. But to create very stable, strong masking tape pattern, you should attach same layers of masking tape along the width of the shoelace. If you want to make shoes and get best results, you should learn shoemaking in certain order. I know it from experience working with my students, and I know it from my own experience. So that's why I created this tutorial where I talk about flat ballet shoes, because this is the first footwear type that you need to make to learn shoemaking and reach best results. There is one common mistake that beginners do in making flat bayou shoes. They get uneven left and right halves of flat bayou shoes. Why? Because they did a wrong lasting. One of the most popular footwear types, flat bayou shoes. Let's talk about materials and tools that you need to make flat bayou shoes. You need to have the shoe last for flat bayou shoe. It must be flexible and stable in the same time. The thickness of this lining is and shoemaking rasp that you will use in many different steps of your work. The thickness of this leather is approximately 4-5 millimeters, and this is how you will manage very accurate cuts, curved lines, straight lines. In my opinion, this is one of the most important steps in shoemaking, and it will help you a lot in making your shoes other footwear types. During lasting, it's very important to last both pairs of your flat bayou shoes parallel to have identical flat bayou shoes. Okay, we cut out only one and now we will cut the second. Vegetable tanned leather is one of the easiest materials to source and make your shoes, and in the same time, this is one of the best materials to make your shoes from, because working with vegetable tanned leather, you can make insoles, counters, shoe soles and heels. Almost each part of shoes you can make from vegetable tanned leather. There are different types, so in this tutorial I show what is the thickness and what is the type of vegetable tanned leather you need to work with to make certain part of your shoes. There are different types of vegetable tanned leather, and today in this tutorial I want to explain you what type of the height we should use in each part of the footwear, what thickness of this part we should use, what thickness of details for women's shoes, men's shoes, and I will try to answer all your questions. Cut it out. Bend it. We place nails on the color the sole like we did in my English welted course. Here we used red color, but you can use whatever you want. This is it for this tutorial, and this is my last tutorial of this year 2020. And I have a lot of plans, a lot of ideas to create many new tutorials for upcoming year 2021. If you are not a subscriber yet to this channel, make sure to subscribe to this channel, because in the next year 2021 you will have a lot of many useful tutorials that you need to make your shoes. I wish you a happy new year, be safe, be happy. I wish you a lot of love and happiness and peace in your family. See you in the next year. Bye.